take that as a yes.
What?
The ring.
The world remains in mourning after the death of Superman. Violence, acts of war, and terrorism are all on the rise.
I had a dream. It was the end of the world.
Invasion.
I think it's something more. Something darker.
People we don't know to risk their lives.
Strong man is strong as alone. You ever heard that? That's not a saying. That's the opposite of what the saying is. And divided, we are not enough. The world needs Superman. Made him a promise. This is why I brought you together.
Ride ain't over yet.
My man.
As a bat signal, that's your... Sorry. That's your signal. That means we have to go now.
Yeah, that's what that means.
It's so cool.
What's going on, guys? I know you've been waiting for this video for a really long time, and you've probably seen a million different breakdowns of the trailer and you're just tired of it now, or maybe you don't care, you've just been waiting for this one. Either way, we're finally going to review or slash break down this trailer of the latest Justice League trailer. I've said trailer like a million times. But I just want to go ahead, and this is going to be kind of a nonchalant review. I'm not going to break down every single part of this trailer like I usually do, but I do want to talk about just certain things with this trailer right off the start. You can definitely tell that this is Joss Whedon's freaking Justice League now. There are still some things from Zack Snyder definitely in there, but I'm pretty sure you've seen some of the comparisons online. But if you look at the second trailer compared to this third trailer, it's a lot more red. And like, there's not all the blue dark tones that you see from a lot of Zack Snyder films. This freaking movie has a lot more color to it. And I gotta say, I'm pretty excited about that. I will 100% say right off the bat that I am a Zack Snyder fan. Whether you love him or hate him, it doesn't really matter to me. I think he is a visually amazing director. And you can say what you want about his storytelling. I won't say he's the best at storytelling, but visually, he is fucking amazing. And I've never really had a problem with the dark blues and stuff, especially when it came to Batman. I thought it worked really well. But when you start looking at Superman and Wonder Woman and all these other characters that are very, you know, vibrant and like, you know, they inspire hope or, you know, prosperity, justice, whatever you want to say, they are not all dark like Batman. Like, the darkness works for Batman. It doesn't work for every other person in the Justice League. To see that Joss is coming in here and he's brightening up the film does make me, as a comic book fan, really excited. And it just makes it a lot more realistic in my eyes. So, like, in this whole thing with this invasion that's happening, the skies are red. And they are so vibrant and red. And everything has this red tone now, opposed to this blue tone that you kind of get the idea that, you know, the skies are red and stuff like that, because there's craziness going on. So I really like that about this trailer that, you know, one thing that I noticed. Now, one thing I will say, the first thing that I did not like about this trailer was the song. And I have to say it has grown on me as I've watched this trailer more, but I just did not like the song the first time I heard it because it didn't feel epic. Like the freaking Junkie XL stuff was just all like, duh, 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 duh. Like you were just like in it and you were just like, oh my God, this is great. Like you were just so into the trailer, at least I was. But then this one was more cinematic, but I just didn't like the vocals. I didn't really like the lyrics. Like, it just wasn't pumping me up for this movie. But as I've watched it a few, you know, 20 times or whatever, I'm excited for it. And it feels more like a movie than it does just like this epic superhero brawl that we're gonna get. And I think it's better. In the long run, I think that is better that these, you know, DC movies are gonna feel more like movies. We got that with Wonder Woman. You know, Wonder Woman proved that the DCU, or whatever they're calling it, because it's officially never been called the DCEU, but, you know, we'll still refer to it as that. That these movies can be great and they can be epic and they can feel like movies that are movies and not just comic book movies. And I'm hoping that's what we're gonna get from Justice League. Last thing I wanna say before we start breaking some stuff down is I am so glad they did not reveal Superman in this. I mean, we saw that one scene, or I should say just this scene right now, might as well just include it, of him in the cornfield and saying like, I'll take that as a yes, talking to Lois Lane. I'm going to say that this is a flashback and it's just her dreaming and you see her waking up in the bed. I do seem like this might actually could be like an opening scene to the movie. Like very early on, we could get this Superman dream. It is looks very dreamlike of him standing in the cornfield and all that jazz. But it's nice to see a happy kind of Superman, or like a, you know, what's going on kind of Superman. So that was cool. But I will say I'm glad we didn't see him in the suit, and they are going to save whatever reveal of him popping out and saving the day or whatever. They're saving that for the movie, and I applaud that because they didn't show, like, they're getting really good with not showing major things like Wonder Woman. They didn't show Ares until like a trailer after the movie had already came out. So I like that. And I'm glad they're doing that here with Superman. And that probably means we haven't even got a little snippet of the last fight. So I'm really excited to see what's going on here. And also, we didn't get a lot of new stuff in this trailer. And I feel like, because like we haven't really got to see Batman fight a lot. We got to see him fighting a little bit in the last one. But I feel like there's going to be a lot of stuff we have not seen. And they kind of just painted the picture of the same kind of things. We're going to give you a little bit different angles of what's happening. But we haven't shown you anything major. At least that's what I'm taking away from this. They could have easily just showed us all the action. But I don't get that feeling from watching this trailer like I do some other big movies, that you feel like you see everything in the trailers. So yeah, let's go ahead and break this down. Like I said, I do think this first intro scene of Superman and Lois Lane is a dream, and that kicks over to the person with the voiceover saying that, you know, Superman's dead and blah blah blah, everything, the world's going to shit. Then we see some big action from Steppenwolf, you know, smashing some horses with his hammer and everything like that. And we just see, this looks like it's going to be part of the opening scene. I don't think there are going to be too many people fighting with horses the second time Steppenwolf comes back, which is basically when he's going to be fighting the Justice League. So all of these intro scenes of like this big war, everybody standing on their horses fighting all these parademons, this is going to be, I think, at the intro of the film. Because remember, Zack Snyder always has these elaborate intros, which is one of my favorite things I love about him. And I think that this might be his elaborate intro for Justice League, which is the backstory of how the first Great War, or whatever they're calling it, happened. And so I do think these scenes are from that. Then we have these two scenes where you hear Wonder Woman saying invasion, and then it cuts to like some scenes, and then Batman's all like, I think it's something more, I think it's something darker. Now that could be referencing Steppenwolf and like how the war's coming and everything, but you do notice that in that scene they are actually in like their suits already, so they're like ready to fight. And I don't think Diana is gonna be just wearing her suit just to wear it, like, oh, I'm gonna go see Bruce, let me put on my freaking Wonder Woman outfit, because she don't do that shit. All right, if she wants Bruce, she's gonna be like, come here bitch, I want you. So I think they just got into some fight. Batman is dressed up, you know, I should say Bruce Wayne is dressed up in the bat suit. So I think something just went down for them to both be in their costumes. And then if he just says like, you know, I don't know, maybe he could be talking about the dream he had, you know, and he feels like something darker is coming, which he does reference the dream in this trailer. But what if he is referencing Darkseid opposed to just Steppenwolf? Because if the parademons start showing up, they're going to show up with Steppenwolf, and we just know that's going to be the bad thing. But what if they got into a little fight already? What if this is like post all the League has got together, they're trying to figure out what's going on, and he says he feels like something darker is coming, and maybe it's freaking Darkseid. I don't think we're going to see Darkseid in this film unless it's a post-credit scene. But I don't think he's going to show up and be like, what's up, guys? I'm Darkseid. I think he'll come out of a later film. But right now, I don't know. I've heard rumors that Joss Whedon actually changed the ending to this film because it was supposed to show Darkseid and it was supposed to go into Justice League 2 when that was going to come out a year or two later. But they scrapped that whole idea, so we have a new... Probably they're going to defeat Steppenwolf and that's just going to be the end of it. Maybe Darkseid, ending at the end, but we'll see what happens. Then we have this little montage of every character just having an epic pose. You see Wonder Woman on the gold statue. You see Batman turning and the freaking Batwing showing up. You have Cyborg looking at what's probably MySpace on his hands. And you just have all of this random, like, cool scenes. Barry Allen smiling. And then, of course, Jason Momoa in the water turning and he's cut. He's like, he's a freaking... cut motherfucker, man. Like, seriously, like, it's unfair that this guy is so cut. It's ridiculous. After that, we get a very Arkham Knight scene where the Batmobile is shooting the cannon of the gun and you just get this epic, like, bullet shell coming out of that. We have this cool little montage of what is gonna probably be the end fight scene because everything's red. It looks like they're just, like, encased in, like, a just red aura of darkness fighting a bunch of parademons and trying to get, I guess, to Steppenwolf or whatever's causing this whole beam of redness. Followed by another montage of everybody kind of fighting on their own. Bruce is talking about how, divided, we're not good enough, but together, we can make shit happen. And we're getting that kind of help. And then we see this scene of this cop, looking up. Could this be when Superman actually arrives? And then the scene after that cuts to Bruce actually looking at like a hologram Superman, which some people thought would be Supergirl, which they're not gonna do that in this film, that's for sure. That would have totally broke a long time ago. But I do think that, that could be Superman maybe coming out of his grave, or maybe that is the first time he actually shows up. Maybe that is, they had to bury something at that monument. What if that's where he goes back to get his suit originally? Because maybe he got buried in the black suit. Maybe he's going to go back there and he's going to change into his, blue and red suit. And that's what's going to make everybody be like, oh shit. Maybe something like that. I feel like he's going to go to the monument for some reason. And maybe that's why all these people are looking up. And there's even those shots of the whole Justice League looking up in the sky. So maybe that's when Superman's going to show up. We don't really know. I feel like Superman is going to show up more in a, I'm going to come save the day kind of thing. Don't forget, we do have that whole scene of Alfred saying, like, he said you'd show up. So there is possibly that as well. Now, there is one thing that Batman says in this trailer that has got me mind-boggling. He says that he made Superman a promise and that he would bring the whole team together. That never happened, unless they're talking about the scene, like, Bruce made that promise to him in his mind, because they legitimately never talked about a promise. Like, it seriously went from, like, I'm gonna kill you, Martha, we're best friends, to, like, is she with you, Superman's dead. Like, that's everything that happened in BVS. So there was no promise made at any point, unless there is, like, some craziness that we don't even know about that's happening in this movie, and that Batman is actually, like, maybe got Superman's body, knows how to bring him back, and he has been, like, recharging him this whole time, like, bringing him back, like, using technology, using whatever, the sun, whatever they're gonna do to bring back Superman, whatever the explanation is. What if Bruce actually took him somewhere to try to bring him back to life? And that would make sense if, he wakes up out of whatever's finally brought him back to life, and Alfred is like, oh, he said you'd show up or whatever. It's possible. That could be a theory. I don't think that's what's going to happen. But that could explain how Bruce made a promise to him. Although I think it's going to be more of those kind of like, oh, you're dead, I'm talking to you. Like, hey, I'm going to bring all these people together to protect the world and in your honor or something like that. So I could see that. I feel like that's going to be more what he means. But every time I hear that in this trailer, I'm like, you didn't talk to him. It's literally Martha. Is she with you? He's dead. Y'all didn't talk. So I don't know. Just want to throw that out there. We have this quick scene right here of, you know, the flying foxes, I think what they're calling this plane, and it is flying into this big orb over here. Now, I do think that this orb is where all of this crazy action with the red sky and everything is going to happen. I think they are going to use this plane, they are going to blow into it somehow, and that is how the Batmobile is going to go into there. Bruce is going to do his whole thing, they're going to land it in there, they're going to have this big epic fight. Aquaman's going to be surfing on parademons and all of that shit. So I think that is what this is basically heading to, the final battle in this part, in this scene is what I should say. And the rest is just epic montages of stuff we've seen mixed with like a little bit newer scenes from the same area. Could be some of the stuff they reshot. And then we just have like this epic, epicness that's going to be happening. And then, of course, it's followed up with this ending scene of Barry just being dorky Barry and be like, oh, look, you know. And I think some people might find that annoying, maybe that Barry's going to be too, like, I don't know, I guess kiddish, I would say. But he's wants friends. Like, it's been very noticed. Like, he joins the team immediately. There's no convincing him. He's just like, I'm in. And he literally says, I need friends. And I think it's just his like nature of wanting to be with people. He has meta powers, and you know, he wants people that are like him. He wants people that are trying to save the world. He needs those kind of people because it's kind of hard to be who he is and not relate to anybody else because, well, he's got, I'm gonna say it, fucking magic powers. But I have no problem with Ezra Miller's portrayal because I feel like this is gonna be more of the Barry Allen from the comic book. If you guys don't read the comic books and you just watched the Flash TV show, which I just saw the first episode of season 4, if you just watch that and you don't read the comic books, it's a very different Flash that you're getting on the TV show. He's not like, in the comic books, he jokes around a lot. And you might have seen that in the, like, you know, cartoons and stuff. They do it a little bit there, although a lot of people are like, oh, that's more Wally West. And it's like, yeah, Wally West does that too. But Barry Allen has always been a jokester in the comics. He always does like these witty kind of things. He's kind of like the way Spider-Man does stuff, but not as, I think Spider-Man's a little bit more, like, not cocky, but, you know, smartass when it comes to fighting his villains. But they're kind of like on the same level. And I think some people are just so like, they're so in tune with the show that they don't think about this is actually the Barry Allen we get from the comic books. So I have no problem with Ezra Miller as Barry Allen. I think he's actually going to steal the show. Him and Aquaman are both probably going to steal this show, and people are going to come out of it like, oh my god, I love Aquaman, I love, you know, the Flash and all of that jazz. But quickly, some people want to know what I'm expecting from this film or what I want to see. I don't know. I just want to see a good film. I want to see something like I did Wonder Woman. I want to be inspired when I watch this film. Like, just leave, like, holy shit. Like, that just made all my fanboy feelings, like, oh, so great. But at the same time, it inspired me to do whatever. Because when I walked out of Wonder Woman, I was all like, I mean, I know I'm a dude, and I know it's probably more empowering for women to watch that. But even when I walked out, I was like, oh, yeah, man, I could fucking take on the world. That freaking, oh, man, that trench scene. I was like, ooh. Like, you know, it's just how it was. And I'm kind of hoping I get the same kind of feeling come out of Justice League. And I'm just hoping it's more, not towards the comics, but more towards the DC universe. Like, we're starting to get this universe that's not so dark. Like, we're going to see the personalities of Flash, Cyborg, Aquaman, Wonder Woman, Batman, and Superman when he comes back. And hopefully, the freaking Green Lantern with those surprise appearance. And I do think that's going to happen. And that is something I want to happen. Apparently, Idris Elba, just throwing it out there. Jeff Johns, if you somehow watch this movie somehow, or not even a movie, it's called a video. But Idris Elba says he wants a bigger part in the Marvel Universe, and they're totally not going to give it to him. So bring him to Justice League. But I just want to see epic action, some really cool Easter eggs, and setting up the universe, but not so much being dependent on setting up this universe. Jeff Johns has came out recently and said how everything is connected, but they want everything to like still be individual and feel a certain way. Like, the Supermans to feel like Superman films, the Wonder Woman films to feel like Wonder Woman films, etc., etc. That's kind of what I want too, because I'm already excited for, you know, Matt Reeves' Batman. I loved, you know, Patty Jenkins' Wonder Woman. I can't wait for her sequel. I'm hearing good things about possible directors for a Superman movie that's getting me excited. And hopefully they score somebody good to do the Flash movie. And I'm excited to see where these characters are going to go and develop in their own solo films. That way when I see those and they come back for a second movie, I'm going to be like, hell yeah, that first Justice League movie was awesome. But now they're like really good characters. We know a lot about them. And the second movie is going to kick ass. and hopefully it won't be like Age of Ultron, because that was a massive letdown. And in case you think I'm hating, I'm not. I fucking loved the first Avengers movie. I was super pumped for Ultron, and it was just a huge letdown for me. And I hope that doesn't happen with Justice League 2, because sometimes the team-up films are really crazy. But, you know, before we even get Justice League 2, we're probably gonna get Suicide Squad 2 and Flashpoint, so we'll see where this universe goes. But yeah, I think that's all I want to see from this film, is I want to see some epic battles that I'm going to want to watch over and over. I'm going to want to go to YouTube and just watch those on my downtime. I want to see just these connections between these characters. And I don't know, I just want, I want just to be in awe and hope that I want to watch this movie over and over again. Because there's not so much. I don't want to say I'm expecting a lot out of this movie. I just hope it's good, and I hope critics like it, and I hate that I say that. But I know if DC gets movies and critics love them, that they will just keep doing what they want to do, opposed to like, oh my god, we got to change things. But I do think over the last few months, they have been changing, like getting really good directors and actors and writers to kind of change up their universe. And hearing Geoff Johns talk about things in recent weeks with all the Comic Cons and stuff dropping, I'm really excited to see what's going to happen, and I cannot wait for Justice League to finally be here. But that's pretty much it, guys. Sorry this took so long. I've just been trying to, sometimes reviewing things so quickly is not my forte recently, but I got a lot of other things going on as well outside of YouTube. But I do want to know what you guys thought of this trailer. Do let me know in the comment sections down below. Don't forget, if you ever want to support this channel, you can check out the Patreon like these awesome people did. Mess that up. You can always check us out on twitch.tv/juicefromthebox, or you can do the OG thing and give this video a thumbs up and share it with all of your Justice League buddies. Memory card died. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button for all things nerdy and geeky on this channel. As always, I am your host, Juicebox. Remember, when you wake up in the morning, ask yourself something. Have I had my daily dose of juice? See you guys next time. Bye.